proposals for membership, and is this you? Still, it is?
It's not local, it's not going to be me.
This is transitioning from you.
Yes, I am Fran.
You're the embodiment of Fran.
Well.
Okay, but can you just give us a quick update of where we need to do some more?
Yeah, so this report is a regular report, and it describes the current representation on the schools forum. The first table identifies the number of
So my understanding is that we need to vote on this, is that right? And so those eligible, excuse me, to vote on this are the school block.
Mainstream
schools block are eligible to vote. So bearing in mind that there will be an impact of the change, financial change for schools following the Secretary of State announcement about the funding for schools and changing funding schools. The underlying principle of this is that we are, as a sector, we are indicated through consultation that we would prefer a minimum funding guarantee of 0.5%. And what we're asking for is for those in favour of supporting that, the outcome of that consultation, just raise their hands for a yes, and then I will ask for the raised hands for any no's or any abstentions. So, for those in favour of the 0.5% increase as a minimum funding guarantee, if you could indicate by raising your hands, all voting members, any against and any abstentions, no, so we are making that decision. Okay, so the second item on which we are to vote is the views on the falling roles and the growth forms for any spare capacity. We like the thought of spare capacity. It appears to be an incapacity, but in the hope that there is some spare capacity, do we need to either approve that in the model we've been using or to not approve it, which is what we think. So for those in favour of that proposal, if you raise your hand. Okay, thank you very much. So unanimous again. And finally, 7.4 is about the potential risk to the all through school, both in the high school academy, and what we've done in the past is applied the formula so that those children aren't disadvantaged and that school isn't disadvantaged by a disproportionate change in their funding because of their primary and secondary, and this guarantees that it keeps them safe, and we've historically all voted to support that. Also, for the record, so for those in favour of maintaining that position, if you could raise your hand.
Sorry, do I need to declare that parents have a child at school?
Yes, you do. in which case you should abstain from that vote. Okay, so for those in favour, 5-1 abstention. Fantastic. Thank you for that declaration. So we have that decision made. Thank you so much for that. Okay, if we can now move on to item 10, which is